Merry New Year!
Happy New Year. In this country, we say Happy New Year.
Thank you for correcting my English with Sting.
Could you give At Marks with Mike's podcast a shout out? Shout out!
Hey, yo!
What a maneuver! Mamma mia! Mamma mia! Are you kidding me?
The irresistible force meeting the immovable object.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of Marks and Mikes. You already know who it is by the sound of my voice. That's right, it's 6'9". JT back in his piece once again, and of course, I'm rolling with my co-host, L. Cheech. What's going on, Bobby?
Yo, what's going on, big man? How's everybody doing in this lovely evening? Let's go, bro.
Let's go, Browns, indeed, man. You know, you already know, like I usually say, I'm laying in the cut like a Band-Aid, trying to make sure that I'm always cooling it. So, you know, definitely, once again, it's 2021, new year. Of course, there's some old shenanigans still popping their head up here and there. But once again, I definitely have to thank everybody for tuning in to this past Friday's episode with none other than Trish Adora. Very fun doing that interview. Had a great time doing the interview. Great conversation. Got a chance to learn about her upbringing in D.C., not Kentucky, as well as, her training and the women that inspired her, and also her upcoming match at Ohio Wrestling Alliance, which is going down January 30th, inside the Franklin Fairgrounds in Hillard, Ohio. Make sure you do get your tickets to the event. If you haven't got your tickets already, it is available at Ohio Wrestling Alliance. You all can definitely get your tickets. It is available at Ohio Wrestling Alliance, Twitter, IG, and Facebook. It is easy to find it. It is the same handle as at Ohio Wrestling A1. Very easy to find them. Click on that link to get your tickets. You can go ahead, buy some group tickets, no more than a group of four, for you to be able to come as a unit. You can split those groups up, of course. We are taking this very, very precautiously, very safely when it comes down to COVID. So everything that you need to know is available at their social media pages, and you can also look on ours. We'll have that posted as well. But man, definitely glad to finally get the chance to link up. We got some exclusive videos that we got to talk about that we're going to drop later on in the upcoming weeks with Marks and Mikes. So man, we got to talk about 2021. Everyone had their first wrestling show this week for their company, right? You had Wrestle Kingdom, you had Raw, but you know, everything. And right out the gate, Raw has the worst show, period. Would you agree with that, man?
Yeah, the expectations were so high in the sense, you know, the legends. You always have that thought, like, how they're going to use them. And it's, to me, they never capitalized on having them around, you know what I'm saying? Instead, they'll have them in backstage, in little bits and shit, you know what I mean? That's why Carlito wasn't for that shit. It was like, I ain't gonna travel across the, you know what I mean, the country just for fucking 2 minutes cameo and shit, you know what I mean? And it kind of sucked, you know what I mean? And I don't know if they went ahead of time, but like, that little part with, you know, with the legends, and then, you know what I mean, throughout the whole night, you see Randy Orton being disrespectful, you know what I mean? Like, to me, with that Mark Henry, I could see Mark Henry having another match just because of that. Because Mark Henry's not the type to just kind of put his head down like, nah, nigga. That's not how he's built. So I could see that just as a, just a match, an attraction match at Mania. You feel me? I could see that. And, but you know what I mean? Like, so, it, like, see what I'm coming from? he comes and disrespecting the legends. But then at the end, you had Goldberg coming out, checking out Drew McIntyre for, like, saying that he don't respect, you know what I mean? So it didn't make no sense, you know, even though I don't know if they actually, you know, in a match went longer than it was, so they have to rush it or whatever. But to me, just, like, come on, man, polish up, right? They didn't make no sense what he was trying to say and shit. So I don't know. What you think?
Man, be honest, bro, like, okay, back to what you said, complete waste. Everyone was expecting, first of all, a lot of people were tuning in just to see Carlito. Even inside a group chat, you was like, yo, I'm going to tune into the first hour of Raw. You know, hopefully Carlito's in the first hour of Raw. And then, of course, I checked the dirt sheets. Carlito's not there. So automatically, bro, I'm already pissed. I'm like, man, come on. I mean, I wanted to see him to have a Carlito's cabana, you know, and spit an apple in somebody's face. Like, you know, but not for no 2-minute backstage segment. Like, yeah, I could see why he was like, nah. I mean, I don't know what happened behind that, if that was the case. But I didn't want to see Hulk Hogan, like, the whole entire night. You know, he opens up the show. We didn't even get the new theme for, you know, Raw. We got Hulk Hogan trying to sell us a fucking H phone. That shit was corny as fuck. All right. Corn all over that, straight corn. And then, you know, you had that going on. And then, you know, I don't know, that silly ass segment with the New Day and Miz and Morrison, like, you know. And then it just seemed like the chemistry and a lot of the matches were off. I mean, the best match of the night was the main event. But it's like, you know, I think the whole entire night got overshadowed by Legends Night, you know, because you're spending so much time with these legends. And it's like, you know, spending all this time, you know, hey, we got this legends. And then majority of the legends that were advertised, you know, a good handful of them didn't even show up. You know, I was happy to see, you know, I was happy to see the majority of them. But, you know, like I said, it was just too much Hogan on the TV screen for me. And that corny ass backstage segment with McIntyre and Hogan and Sheamus, like, nah, B, that wasn't it. However, you did have the whole thing with Angel Garza bringing up Cardi B, and then Cardi B and fucking Cardi B had a little Twitter beef with Lacey Evans. That shit was like the highlight of wrestling Twitter last week, what have you. But you know, I mean, Goldberg coming back, another match. Is this something that you want to see in 2021 at this point?
It's something that is more like for business wise. You know, that's how Ben sees it. You know what I mean? Going into WrestleMania, you want to sell, you know what I mean? You got to be big. So there's no name, big names. You know what I mean? There's no name. That's why they always got to go back, you know what I mean, into the well and dig them, you know what I mean? They're not, you know, like I said before, they're not making no more stars bigger than Hogan, Cena. Cena was the last one, you know what I mean? They don't want nobody to be bigger than the actual WWE, you know what I mean? And they have to go back and get this nigga, you know, the people, you know what I mean? No, they don't have to, but on the business side, they know that it will generate, you know, somehow. You know what I mean? But like, for us that we truly like kind of like hit with it, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you know what I mean? Like, no, just build somebody else. You know what I'm saying? You can make somebody else and book them right. So it kind of like, I don't want to see it, but I understand why they doing it. You know what I mean? And it was kind of like a curveball because, you know, that's why, you know what I mean? Like, rumor is a rumor, but like, you know, things will get out. Accordingly to the rumor in the window, it was going to be Roman against Goldberg, which I kind of wanted to see that. It ended up happening last year, You know what I mean? But it's just kind of like you just come out of nowhere and you're just going to get a title.
It didn't happen last year.
I know it didn't. That's what I'm saying. But it ain't happened. You know what I mean? I know it ain't happened, but like I wanted, you know what I mean? People wanted to see it. You know what I'm saying? Because at the time, last year. But now this year, Goldberg coming in with no, you know what I mean? No kind of build up. You know what I mean? And straight to a match. So that's taken out of the equation. You know what I'm saying? So most likely the winner of the Rumble is going to be facing Mr. Head of the Table over there in SmackDown. You know what I mean? But the you know what I mean? I understand. You know what I mean? What is business? Dude, I'm like clamoring like, yeah, I want to see it. Like, nah, not really. I'd rather see the heel Keith Lee, you know, her business swagged out, you know what I mean? But he still need to polish up, I guess, according to Junior.
Yeah, but I kind of feel like, I mean, I already knew that he wasn't going to win the belt that night, but, you know, it's kind of like I'm glad they let him main event. The main event it again, and it wasn't the first time main event, but
that's it. That's where he should be at. Like people like him, Kevin Owens, you know what I mean? That's where they should be built as, you know what I mean? The main event, because we know the talent, you know what I mean? The only thing, you know, he can be, you know, for long term, you know, Keith Lee has to unfortunately kind of, you know, they changed his style of how he go, you know what I mean? And I think that was kind of detrimental for him. But, you know, they're TV, so they want to see it for certain product or whatever. So I guess, you know, he's restricted to, you know what I mean, doing certain things, you know, as a person of his size.
Yeah, but we all know that Keith Lee can do a lot more than what they let him. But, you know, other than that, if it wasn't for that main event saving the show, that show was booty meat. Didn't like it at all. You know, and I think Mustafa Ali said it best. He really did. You know, what Mustafa Ali, he pretty much said, just to paraphrase, it's like, hey, you got all these legends, you know, taking up TV spots from, you know, people that could have been, you know, on television on the card. No appearance by Retribution at all, period. There were a lot of people that didn't appear on Raw. But, you know.
We see them often. That's the thing. And then like, oh, wow, I haven't seen this. Wow, you know what I mean? Even fucking Tatanka fell out of place. What the fuck?
Yo, Tatanka.
You know what I mean? Tatanka, like, in the back, like, he couldn't be, like, I don't know, some type of other promo, whatever. He's, like, in the back, like, you know what I mean? Melina was kind of dope, but the thing, it's just the back. What can you incorporate it different? Even if, like, they could come to the ring and be in somebody's corner.
Right.
You know, switch it up, bitches, you know?
You know, just got them backstage seven, like, honestly, I would have liked Tatanka to come out and have a match with a heel. But that's a, you know, that's a whole nother can of worms.
Yeah, I want to see D-Lo. I know D-Lo's with Impact, but I know who let him down, you know, just have his head shake. Like one of them back. And like, see D-Lo in the backstage, Tajiri, you know what I mean? Fucking, but on some real shit, Carlito, like I was looking forward to it. Like I told you, I watched the first hour. I ain't see him. I'm like, man, I finished this the next day or whatever. And it would suck, you know what I mean? But, you know, he got pulled, you know what I mean? Because right now, you know, his father's promotion back in Puerto Rico and Savio Vega promotion, they doing, you know, like a exchange of talents that we might say, you know, if you will. And, you know what I mean? So it got popping. So he got an alternative. He, you know, be wrestling down there, you know, for, you know, down in Puerto Rico. And they're recording. So, you know, everything changed. You know what I mean? So now they, you know, they got to produce a program. So, you know, now you have you know, they recording like some shows and stuff like that. But yeah, man, moving on. Yeah, I don't. It's just sad, you know what I mean? It's just so much expectation, especially the first show, you know what I mean? And it was like, man, it goes down, but fuck it. But yeah, you know, we move on.
Yeah, we got to move on. So, you know, Impact had a hell of a, you know, pay-per-view special this past Saturday. I mean, I'm only covering it now because Impact's usually on a Tuesday. But, man, first of all, got to give a major shout-out to Trey Lamar. Making this
that was big. Yo, that was big.
One time for the home team. You know, making his pay-per-view debut. You know? X Cup. It's inside the X Cup too. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's big, bro. So many people have became stars from that X Cup, you know, just over the years of the people that's been in it, especially people that, you know, who had never been in Impact before. And just to see Trey come out with music that he didn't pick, by the way, you know, he said, you know, he wanted to clarify that. It's like, yo, by the way, I did not pick this music. It's like, but, you know, it was definitely big seeing that, bro, because it's like, we get to see, you know, what we got to see him do his thing here in Cleveland, with AI Dub, and, you know.
Yo, and to me, like, that connection, too, like, because, you know, Alice Shelley is over there. You know what I mean? And, you know, those matches, you know what I mean? Like, he put on for him, you know? And it was great. Like, for me, you know, I was hanging with my daughters. I had all my daughters this weekend. And one of my daughters' name is Genesis. So, you know, it's like, you know what I mean? I was with her, so I was like, Genesis on. You know, so the nice tournament rack, you know what I mean? Who was facing that match with Crazy Steve, man? Talk about it.
Yo, Crazy Steve and Trey was it's the first time I've ever seen them go head to head, but that was a good pairing. That was a very good pairing far as the styles that we got out of it. You know, you got the fast, high flying style of Trey versus, of course, Crazy Steve, who's a little bit more mat based as well. But man, when I tell you, like, the mind games that were played by Crazy Steve during that match, and just, you know, just seeing, first of all, seeing Trey being able to hold his own with him inside that match, I mean, it definitely came out to be good. But you know, unfortunately, our boy Trey didn't come out with the dub. You know, Crazy Steve ended up, you know, getting the diving DDT for the dub, and that was pretty much it. But at the end of the day, Trey looked like a young stud out there, you know, and I'm pretty sure that this is not the last that we've seen of him on Impact. I'm pretty sure there's going to be some more appearances, whether that be on Explosion or whether that be on the actual Impact weekly episode, but it's definitely
if they smart, man, they keep them around for them rounds. Cause I bet you, cause of this match, you know the people in Orlando's already like, yo, what's up, baby, you know what I mean?
Right.
Next thing you know, fuck it, they'll be like, you know what? We want you to, you know, practice, whatever. We're going to send you to the UK. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? They got that pool, you know what I mean? But he will fit perfect. And the thing, he's young. He's learning. And you know how it is now? You got competition. You know what I mean? Tony Khan. You know what I mean? So, like, Impact better not sleep on homeboy, man. They need better, like, keep him around, you know what I mean?
Keep him close by. Because there's so many companies right now that are looking for young stars, young stud. You know, you got MLW, AEW, NXT. But speaking of MLW, we're going to get there in a second, yeah. But we're going to take a real quick break. What's up, y'all? Listen, I got to tell y'all about Anchor. Anchor is one of the easiest platforms you can use to go ahead and make your podcast. First of all, it's free. Second of all, it's free. Third of all, did I mention that it's free? Go ahead and download the Anchor app inside your app store. You can go ahead and get your podcast on many platforms such as Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and many more platforms. Anchor has all the tools that you need right at the palm of your hand. What you waiting for? Go ahead and download Anchor and start your podcast. And we are back. Look, listen, very simple. You want to do a podcast? Go ahead, download the Anchor app and start your podcast. I just told you this. Why am I repeating this? Anywho, back to the Genesis card, man. Yo, the whole entire bracket was definitely, you know, worth watching. I mean, a lot of other young studs on the card, you know, doing their thing as far as getting their chance to shine during this X Cup. You know, qualifying matches, you know, you had Casey Navarro going up against Blake Christian. Of course, Blake ended up coming out with the dub on that one. And then you had Daivari, which we'll talk about Daivari in the next segment here. You know, Daivari going up against Cousin Jake. You know, Cousin Jake ended up coming out with the dub on that one. And then, you know, we get down to the semifinals. You know, you got Ace Austin versus Cousin Jake, of course, Madman Fulton out there accompanying Ace Austin. Ace Austin coming out with the dub again. And then, of course, Crazy Steve, Blake, you know. Of course, Blake Christian ends up coming out with the dub on that. When we get to the finals of the J Cup and, I'm sorry, of the X Cup. And, of course, it is Ace Austin going up against Blake Griffin and
Christian.
Hello, did I say Blake Griffin? Isn't that Isn't that the dude that plays for the Pistons? Yeah, it's Detroit. Yo, my bad, Christian Blake. I don't know why he's on my mind right now, but you know,
Blake Christian.
Did I say Blake Christian or did I say Christian Blake?
Christian Blake. Yeah, that's his AKA. But yeah, Blake Christian, man, he showed out, man. That's another cat that, you know what I mean, they should keep him around because that dude's a stud.
Yo, I cannot believe I just said this man's name wrong three times and you finally corrected
me. Oh, no, man. It's just deep in Iran.
Deep in Iran myself, man. I need to get out. If y'all could see, my eyes are like bloodshot. But, anywho, you had Blake Christian end up, you know, in the finals with Ace Austin. And, of course, you know, Ace Austin comes out with the dub, which is, you know, definitely good for, you know, Ace Austin because there are rumors going around, hey, where's Ace Austin? What's going on? And, you know, he's back. You know, he ain't going nowhere. Trust me. Impact is not letting go of Ace Austin no time soon. But two of the matches I definitely wanted to point out there, man, one of them being Jordan Grace ended up challenging Jazz. Jazz, of course, legend, ECW legend, knocking people out, fighting dudes, intergender wrestling. You know, also a legend inside WWE, you know, former women's champion. You know, just to see her come back because the last time we had her on the show, she was talking about, you know, going out and doing some more rounds, but now just as recent, you know, she's telling us about possibly retiring. When she was on the show, she was the NWA Women's Champion. But with that being said, man, this match was definitely a match that I didn't think could be this well put together. When it came down to Grace versus Jazz, man. I mean, for Jazz to come out, have this match one-on-one, I mean, it was a pretty stellar match. I mean, of course, this Jordan Grace ended up coming up with the win, you know. She countered the schoolgirl and basically ended up getting the dub. But I know that's not the last that we've seen of Jazz, because Jazz is definitely always going to put on a great show. But I just like the fact that, you know, I got to see her in a one-on-one match, because I haven't seen her in a one-on-one match in a minute. know what I mean? It's like the last time I seen one of those, I want to say it was NWA. But definitely, I would say I want to see more jazz. Even if jazz goes for a knockout title run, like, I would like to see that. But the main event of that card was definitely well worth it, bro. Moose versus Willie Mack? Bro, did you see when my man gave Willie Mack a go to hell off the top rope and went outside through the table?
Yeah, man, that shit crazy. Wasn't that like a little botch, you think? You know, because, man, I cringed, yo.
I think the whole wrestling community cringed on that one, bro. I'm looking at it, and for a second, it's like I seen the way Willie Mack kind of, you know, his way his head was positioned, and I don't think they caught all of that table. But I do know that, you know, regardless of the fact that was a live crowd in there, holy shit, would have been ringing out that whole entire arena, bro. Like, seriously. But, you know, these big guys, big fellas, I mean, so agile, so strong, but also able to move swiftly. I mean, you had Mack out there doing 6-star frog splashes. You had Moose out there giving spears left and right. I mean, for Moose to be, you know, of course, you know, coming from a football career and transition and be able to be a good, I ain't gonna say good, a great, great performer at this stage in his career is definitely nothing more short than, you know, miraculous. Remarkable. You know, because there's been some duds out there, bro, that's came from the NFL. You know, who can ever forget Mongo McMichael?
Oh no, that's crazy. Mongo Monday. No, but Moose to me, if he goes NXT, he'll benefit from going to NXT, because to me he's still a little rough around the edges, although he still show out whatever, but there's something missing, you know what I mean, to me, you know what I mean. It was kind of dope because in New Orleans, I don't know if you remember, the first guy that I saw coming off the thing, it was him. It was like, oh shit, you know what I mean. So it was kind of dope that I got to see him, and so it was cool, you know, when a particular, you know what I mean, wrestler you meet, they court you, you know, they treat you cool, you know what I mean? So it's kind of, you remember them, but yeah, the Impact, you know, better keep them, you know what I mean? Because everybody else making moves, you know what I'm saying? Because Wednesdays are stacked, you know what I mean?
Wednesdays are stacked, bro.
And MLW sure deliver. Talk about
them. Bro, yeah, we got to speak on that, man. Yo, MLW, first of all, King of Coliseum was definitely a pay-per-view type vibe to it, you know, far as like, it had like a big fight feel to it. You know, it didn't feel like, you know, a little stage, you know, storyline and every, no, it was a big fight feel. And every single match on there was a big fight feel, man. I mean, even some of the revelations that we got, you know, as far as dealing with Contra, you know, we talked about Daivari, who was on Genesis, right? Well, turns out he's a part of Contra as well.
So, Contra! Hell, Contra! Oh, and who was there with him? The real head of the table.
The real...
Yeah.
The real head of the table, bro. Listen, you ain't gonna get me shot. Look, listen, Jacob Fatu, hands down, man. Big, 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 big Umaga vibes.
Big, but, big business.
Big business, bro. And the thing about it is, he's not as big as all the other Samoans, like far as, you know, body mass and everything. But he could still, like, he could beat your ass and, like, you know, pretty much fuck you up. Who are they going up against? I'm on the wrong card and shit.
Yo, you fucking kid.
Don't worry about me, bro. Hello. It's Lust to Edit. Can tell you this right off the top. Big fight, Phil. First match on that card, Devon Eriks. Going up against the Dirty Blondes, you know, real quick match, like 4 minutes, what have you, you know, still building that tag team division, which is good. You know what I'm saying? You know, building that tag team division is a must. But we move on from there, and we end up having another banger of a match, which I didn't think we were going to get that early. But remember, there's a two-part to this whole entire thing. That's from what you were telling me. So it's going to be two parts, two nights. So which means this was just night one. Upcoming this Wednesday is going to be night two. But the next match on that card was for the MLW Middleweight Championship. You know, you had Leo Rush, former Summer Show, going up against Myron Reed, MLW Champion, who's going to be down at Ohio Wrestling Alliance Good Trouble coming up January 30th. Just want to plug that real quick. Make sure you get your tickets. But, you know, this match, bro, I didn't know what to expect because we had, like, pretty much, you know, I'm not going to say same style of fighter, but you had, you know, two fighters that can equally match each other on each level. And that match, like, you and I, we watched it live. But, you know, that match, bro, it was definitely worth it. And I believe that was the first time they've ever faced each other, right?
And, yeah, like you said, they match up pretty good, you know what I mean? And I believe, yeah, it was the first time they ever faced. And it was, like, inevitable, you know, one of those matches that, you know, like, you know what I mean? It should happen. You know what I mean? Like, it was like Trey Lamar versus Lee Moriarty. You know what I'm saying? You know that match has to happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, and like Leo Rush haven't, you know, missed a step. You know what I mean? And Myron Reed, you know what I mean? He put on, you know what I mean? Although, you know, after the match, he got put down, you know, like, oh, contra! But, you know, it is what it is. But yeah, that match was pretty dope, man.
Yo, every part of that match was though, like, there was parts during that match where, you know, Leo, of course, being so damn fast, bro. It's like, you know, he's bouncing from the ropes, you know, he's basically juking him this direction, that direction, and then, you know, that springboard stunner, that frog splash, man, like, you know, like, that's a match that they gotta run back again. Like, I need like two more of those matches, bro.
I'll run it back. Nah, you know what I mean? They, you know, the cell, you know what I mean? Like, it had that big match feel too, you know what I mean? I guess. And the thing was, you know, it was an hour, you know what I'm saying? And I was wrong. I thought it was a two, you know what I mean? But I guess the other match when Hammerstone fights Jacob Fatu, I think that's at a later date, you know what I mean? So I don't think it's a two-part Coliseum, so my bad. That's on my...
Well, shit. Whenever they do have another little pay-per-view event, make sure you put Leo versus Myron Reed part two. I got to see that again. Another match that happened during that card, you had Alexander Hammerstone going up against Mads Kruger, right? Double count out.
Yeah, and it's crazy because I like how Kurt Bauer, you know what I mean, he books Dude, because let's keep it 100. Dude is not like, it seems like he got too much in his arsenal. But the way Kurt Bauer books it, you know what I mean? They expose you know, his good qualities and the ones that he's not too good, you know what I mean? They hit him, even though you could see in some parts, you know, man, hesitation or whatever, but still, my dude, like, you know, Hammerstone still showed out, you know what I'm saying, in the sense of, like, how the match went along, you know what I'm saying, for somebody that seems to be green, you know what I mean? But to me, I was entertained, you know, for that match, because I'm Hammerstone, I'm going on him, and, you know, dude's doing his thing, I guess his girlfriend, battling cancer, so that's kind of, you know what I mean, I kind of, you know, relate to that, because, you know, I did go through that, so hearing stories like that, kind of like, then, you know, you want to root for the dude, you know what I mean, positive vibes.
Yeah, positive vibes only, man, definitely, you know, continue to fight that good fight. A lot of people out there fighting, and you're right. It does make you want to root for him because he's fighting for something more than himself at this point. But, of course, the show ends up ending in chaos. And I didn't mind it because the simple fact, cliffhanger, right? You don't know what's going on. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So that cliffhanger is what it's all about, you know? Not knowing what's going to happen next, so you got to tune in next week. It's going to make you want to watch. You know, you ain't got no choice but to watch, you know what I mean? But Wednesdays are set. So let's talk about, of course, AEW Dynamite, which we were kind of debating, like, which one, who was going to watch which show. So you end up watching Dynamite. So, bro, you got to tell me big moments from that show that you definitely, you know, that you took away from Dynamite this past Wednesday.
Well, you know, of course, that first match was a clusterfuck with, you know what I mean, SCU and Young Bucks, and, you know what I mean, against the John Cena's or whatever the fuck they call, you know what I mean, and,
the Acclaim.
Yeah, the Acclaim. You know what I mean? The match, you know what I mean? It was what it was. But, you know, the highlights, you know what I mean? The fact that you had Snoop Dogg actually come out, bring out fucking Cody Rhodes, right? You know, he, like a burst, like, oh shit, you know what I mean? Dude decided, for some reason, you know, the Puerto Rican has to take the bump for Snoop Dogg, that he came out in the match. It was Cody against Matt Sydal, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, it was a pretty good match. But somehow, you know, they go to the outside. And if you notice, they don't do that often, you know what I'm saying? And they went outside and somehow, Serpentico, right? Serpentico. And got him in the between the match and stuff like that. And Snoop Dogg trying to come for the save. He trying to do a frog splash. That is like, my dude, that's a wrestler. You a great singer. Rapper. You know what I mean? Like, dude, he wasn't it. But, you know, there was a lot of things. You know what I'm saying? Like, with the task, the group, you know, coming out, you know, then you see Sting and Darby Allin, as you could tell, like, they having some type of, you know what I mean, synergy, you know what I mean, like, or some sensei shit, you know what I mean, and eventually that's gonna lead into a match between Darby and Sting, in my Monday Night Quarterback, you know what I mean? But man, the highlight of that fucking night, man,
speak on it.
You know, man, you know, Abaddon and the chick, the champion, whatever her name is,
Sheeta,
fucked up, yeah, Sheeta Badabita. But that match was Basura, you know what I mean? It could have been a lot better. But that Rey Fénix and Kenny Omega, right? I believe, I could be wrong, but the first time I seen him wrestle was for the belt that he still has, the AAA Championship, Mega Campeonato. Rey Fénix was the champion, and Kenny Omega beat him, you know what I mean? So I knew once they announced it, it's like, they got chemistry, they going in. And that match was what it was. But it's like, that's one thing about AEW. Like, when you think it's dying out, they boom, they hit you with something else. Like, oh, shit. You know what I mean? That Impact, AEW relationship seems, you know what I mean, that's coming to fruition. You had the fucking Good Brothers, Carl Anderson, and Doc, bro, it was just the thing. Because just before that, okay, boom, you see John Mathley come out with a fucking bat, you know? And it's like, wow, like, you know, boom, boom, hitting you. Next thing you know, wow, you have those coming out, you know what I mean? And then you had, like, the Young Bucks, so you had the cease and desist sign. Although they said that was a lie, you know what I mean? I don't know if it's true or not, that it was an actual truth. They just said that they had a cease and desist from WWE, but who knows? But, man, the Bullet Club, you know what I mean? Let's keep it 100, you know what I mean? The Too Sweet. And that's how they went out the show, you know what I mean? It was like, wow, that shit was crazy. Cause,
mind-blowing.
Yeah, man, because it's like 2021, you seen this shit, like, wow, that's dope, that shit could happen, you know what I mean? And bro, the sky's the limit, and you got, you know, of course, Impact coming up with, you know, the Hard to Kill, you know what I mean? That shit's going to be dope, you know what I mean, lining up everything. But, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? There was that match with Swagger, Jake Hager, and Warlord. And did I say Warlord? Is that his name? The Warlord. Warlow. Anyway, dude from Cleveland, you know what I mean? So I was rooting for them. The match at first, it was sloppy, you know what I mean? But, you know, the young cat got over. But, yeah, man, it was though you had Jericho on commentary. It's always, you know what I mean, entertaining. But, yeah, that Good Brothers and, you know, the Impact Tag Team Champion and AEW, you know what I mean? It was like, wow, that's just, it was dope, you know what I mean? And, you know, they all, you know, NXT delivered too, don't get me wrong, but it's just the moments, giving you moments, pop, pop. It's like, yo, you know what I mean? AEW is like the talk of the town, you know what I'm saying? And although, you know, not talking about ratings, but, you know, just unfortunately with, you know, the events that happened in Washington, you know what I mean? Everybody was just glued to the TV. So good at shows, but they barely made it to 700, you know what I mean? Thousand or whatever the fuck, and you know, it is what it is, but I enjoyed both nights, you know what I mean? But bro, that I don't know, you more kind of marked out when you see that Dito motherfuckers popped up out of nowhere.
Yeah, I did. I really, really did, man. I definitely night one was dope. I gotta give that to AEW. But also New Year's Evil, gotta give it to them too, because New Year's Evil, you know, put on a hell of a show to go up against, you know, far as trying to follow, right? Like, I believe if these two shows came on at, you know, different times, let's just say, you know, NXT was first, then AEW would have to follow what happened. Like, both of these was real good, man. I mean, you know, Great cards. Damian Priest versus Karrion Kross out the gate. NXT hit you right in the mouth with it. Like, fuck it. We just gonna hit you right in the mouth with a match that y'all been waiting to see. You know, Priest looked phenomenal, man. Like, Punishment Martinez, he looked good in this match. Well polished. You got the thing with his push going up and down, and it's like, you know, are they going to push or are they going to pull him back? Push, pull him back. But at the end of the day, it's like, I like the fact that, you know, they are giving him a chance to go back and forth with the wins, because it doesn't make him feel indestructible. You know, it kind of humanizes him in a sense. But at the same time, it's like, you know that his, I guess you could say, his big moment is coming up soon for that NXT title, the NXT championship. Like, I could feel it. Of course, Karrion Kross end up comes out with the dub. But the next match on that card, yo, Santos Escobar versus Gran Metalik.
Oh, man, they show out.
Yeah, they did, you know, bro.
Gran Metalik, that dude, you know what I mean? He got the talent, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm pretty sure he got a match for a reason. Nah, let me stop. No, but you know what I mean? He could go, bro. That dude could go. So it'll be kind of dope, you know what I'm saying? Seeing him get the opportunity. You know what I mean? The opportunity that he's getting. You know what I mean? Because he definitely delivers every time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but he also delivered a botch in that one as well. I mean, but, you know, there were a few botches during that match. But, man, I was watching the match with my son. So me and my son are watching the match, and he's all glued to the screen. Yeah, you know, every time you know, one of these guys come across and do a springboard, do a tope suicida, like, my son would literally, like, lunge forward, you know, just to see what's going on. So, you know, definitely called my attention, definitely called Jaden's attention. But, you know, it was a good match, I guess, to continue to build Escobar. But at the end of the day, what does this leave Lucha House Party? Like, are they NXT bound, or are they going to go back on Raw?
They main event. You know what I mean? Wherever they need them. You know what I mean? It was unfortunate, but they don't know how to book them unless it's like a kind of comedy act. You know what I mean? Not comedy act, but you know what I mean. Gran Metalik should be having matches. You know what I mean? We saw what he did with AJ Styles and stuff. And of course, you know, unfortunately, he's going to have them botches because his type of style of wrestling, you know what I mean? But that match, you know what I mean? They needed a good match. So it's like, dude, why not put dude with him? You know what I mean? So is he back down there? No, I don't know. To me, it's, but they're not using them anywhere else, you know. And then it's fucked up. You, like I said, you see them on main event and, I don't know, wrestling challenge.
that's my whole thing. It's like, why not utilize those guys down there? You know, you got so much going on. You got 205 Live where you can, you know, build these guys up, you know, a little bit more. Especially if you're just going to use them for, like, you know, slapstick comedy. Like, why not put them back in NXT? But, you know, the next match, yo, this right here, this was the match that I was looking forward to. You had Xia Li with Boa. Yo, when I tell you, when she came out, and whoever the hell that is sitting on that throne, which I think is Karen Q, but yo, this debut made me extremely more vested into Xia Li's character, bro. My God. Like, in the words of Maro, there are no words. Like, yo, she came out and out the gate and just basically she looked like a whole different character. Like this metamorphosis. And the thing is, it's always been there. But man, I've never been so more invested. Like, you know, I put the tweet out there. It's like, you know, after this match, which she ended up facing Katrina Cortez. But after that match was over, and it wasn't even a long match, but it was still a good match. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Zia Lee.
Them kicks. They were lethal. Like, yo, and she looked good. Like, the whole presentation with Boa. And, bro, it gave me that Kill Bill vibes, you know
right?
What I mean? And that's dope as fuck, you know what I mean? And the dude, what should be Tajiri? That'd be funny as fuck. But, man, it give you that, you know, it's a storyline that if they do it right, it's kind of, you know, dope. It's entertainment, you know what I'm saying? But, man, they could do so much shit like that. And Shorty look strong, you know what I mean?
But, yeah, but if they do it, bro, like you said, they have to keep that same presentation, that same story to continue to go, like with her proving herself to, you know, whoever this mysterious figure is. We're going to put that out there. But each and every week after she wins, like, continues to prove herself. But I can see her going for the NXT women's strap. Give me a solid 90 days of booking with Zia Lee. And I would love to see Zia Lee versus Io. I would love to see that. You know, man, I just think that match would be dope. I really do. But, you know, the next match on that card, last woman standing's match. Once again, the women of NXT putting on Rhea Ripley
versus
Raquel Gonzalez. Speak on it, yo.
Yo, Raquel Gonzalez is that shut your mouth. No, she is putting on. She demolished Rhea. You know, and of course, I said the rumor innuendo, but, you know, she's being called up or whatever. That's for blah, blah, blah. Who cares? That match, the storyline, you know what I mean, that they had going in, had me invested, you know what I mean? And, fuck, man, they did a hell of a fucking job. Even though, of course, they put it like, yeah, it had to take two people to beat me, you know what I mean, type of deal. So, you know, at least it's like Rhea still was booked strong in the BF, you know. But shit, that match, brother, it was good. And it's dope seeing Raquel, you know what I mean, being used the right way, you know, like that bad bitch. I'm saying it's your bad bitch, bro.
Yo. Raquel Gonzalez, I'm telling you, keep her in NXT for the next year. Solid booking. Whenever they call up to the main roster, or should I say the other roster, she's going to be so solid, bro. Like, she looks strong. She knows how to move strong. And just think about this. Think about this. 8 months ago, when she first came into the fold, no one's seen this much potential. But man, looking at her now, it's a totally different story, bro. Like, when you go back to when she first debuted inside the Mae Young Classic, you know, seeing her then and seeing her now, yo, total metamorphosis. I'm definitely with it. Continue to evolve. Continue to evolve, like, seriously.
Yeah, before she had that little like Stan Hansen type of gimmick, you know,
yeah,
on the horn song, you know, and it kind of fit her because, you know, she's from Texas or whatever. But she reinvented herself, and bro, like, I love you. I love you, Raquel. No, but bro, she's killing it, bro. And that's dope, cause that's a good problem to have. You know what I mean? The big, too big, you know what I mean? Woman, talk, you know what I mean? That could go, you know what I mean? That's like monster, bro. Like, you know, Rio, of course, I would rather see him as heels, you know what I mean? But Raquel, I could see that she's going to be bigger, that when she make that turn, she's going to be bigger. You feel me? Start as a heel and then, oh man, the future is bright for that young lady.
Man, definitely bright. But, you know, shout out to Rhea Ripley, you know, going out on a high note and putting Dakota Kai inside of a locker. But definitely, you know, shout out to her. But the main event for that night, before we get to the main event, we had an impromptu match because the fight case match couldn't happen between Thatcher and Ciampa because of an injury. But impromptu match, Gargano and Candice LeRae versus Kushida and Shotzi. Yo, out of nowhere, the match ended up being dope. Like, the match wasn't even planned, bro. And it still ended up being a dope match. Like, that's when you know that everything is clicking on all cylinders. Like, you know, both of these, I'm sorry, all four of these competitors inside this match, you know, were able to show off. You know, Austin Theory, you know, definitely doing his best to get that camera time, man, because he is definitely the yes man, the yes man to Johnny. But I could definitely see eventually, you know, him asking for a title shot. I could definitely see that happening. But the main event, bro, Finn versus O'Reilly. Balor versus O'Reilly, bro.
Part two.
Yo, how do you top the first one? By doing a part two. And this one was just as good as part one. You know, no broken jaws or, you know, major injuries, but yo, this match was just as good as the first one. It's like
wrestling.
Yeah, give me a part three. Give me a part three with these guys. Like, I need a part three. Real talk. Like, once again, Kyle O'Reilly proving why he was one of the most sought out people when his contract was up. You know, you got people that want to sign Kyle O'Reilly now as soon as his contract is up, but. You know, shout out to both of these guys, man. Like, you know, and then Finn actually winning the match with a submission, though. Like, actually a submission? Like, yeah. I haven't seen him win with a submission yet. Have you?
Yeah, I believe he, back in New Japan, he had.
Yeah, New Japan. But, NXT.
Yeah. Yeah, but, you know, but I'm talking about, like, you know, I know he had that in his arsenal, you know what I mean? And he started using it. And if you think about him, a lot of, you know, the greats, once they, you know, in the game for many years, they start getting other, you know, finishes and shit. And they usually be, you know, finishers, you know what I'm saying? Like that, you know, like the Undertaker, you know, remember the Undertaker Tombstone, but then he had the other one.
That you was know? Gay.
Yeah, so, yeah, I don't know, it's good because, you know what I mean, Finn Balor should be, you know, in a higher spectacle, you feel me? And hopefully they don't, much more to change their mind, hope they keep going with it. You know, Killer Cross don't need that belt. You know, he could go after it, I guess. That'll be a good match or whatever. But Killer Cross needs to get polished too. And eventually that match is going to happen. But, you know, so that hell of a match. And, you know, of course, you know, they mentioned, they announced that the Dusty Rhodes going to have the women's.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Dusty guy. and the dude, so that's kind of dope, you know what I mean? They already announced some of the people. So NXT looking forward, you know, the takeover. And, you know, NXT is the best wrestling show on TV, you know what I mean? Hands down, you know. Oh, when it comes to wrestling, you know, NXT is where it's at, you know. And it don't reflect on the numbers and the ratings and all of that shit, you know what I mean? If you know, you fucking know.
Yo, my thing is for the women, right? We know that, you know, with the Dusty Cup, you get a trophy, and eventually you get a tag team championship match. But on the women's side, right, when whichever team wins the the women's Dusty Cup, are they going to get a title shot at the women's tag team championship? Or is it just going to be a trophy? That's the big question. But, of course, we had to close out with SmackDown, right? That show of the week, far as, you know, I ain't going to say best show of the week for wrestling. Let's just say the last show of the week for wrestling, right? You got, of course, you know, SmackDown on Fox, which is the perfect move for them because they're able to definitely get a bigger audience. And, you know, the ratings proved why, you know, it was good to move them to Fox. But, you know, SmackDown to me this past week was the best wrestling show next to NXT, you know, that was produced that week. One thing that hit me right out the gate was, you know, you having Big E going up against Apollo Crews, right? Both of these guys on separate brands. You had, you know, Apollo Crews, former United States champion, you know, they had that storyline with him, and then he fizzled out. They moved him to SmackDown, and here he is going for another scrap. But I like the fact that he got some, you know, he got some fuck it in the system. Like, all right, fuck it, let's go. Like, you know, I like that. But once again, is it me, or is he just one of those wrestlers that just needs a mouthpiece?
Who?
Apollo Crews.
Yeah, man. Does he need one back? Because even he looked, you know what I mean? He got a great look. But when he talks, it's like, hey, I'm going to eat you too. You know, some Mike Tyson shit. Even though, you know, don't get me wrong, Mike Tyson, I love Mike Tyson. But he don't got that messy. It's the same with Ricochet. Ricochet is the devil. When he start talking, they're like, man, what the fuck? It's annoying. Yeah, he could use somebody with a stick, man. And I don't know, man. Like that, you gonna bring some legends over? Why don't you bring somebody to be like their mentor? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Let somebody talk for him, you know. But you know, his in ring ain't nothing wrong with the in ring. But you know, as far as the person watching home, it's definitely, you know, that mic. Like, you know, he definitely gives off the vibes that he'll beat your ass, but it's like, as soon as he opens up his mouth, it's like, I ain't scared of you. It's like, and that's what it boils down to. It's like, yo, he got the look like he'll fuck you up, but it's like, you know, once he starts talking, it's like, you know, man, sit your ass down, right? But you also, you know, that match, of course, Big E comes out on top. Good match, though, overall. I mean, definitely a match that was talked about all over Twitter. Then you had the tag team titles, man. The Street Profits going up against Ziggler and Rude. And I can't believe it. New tag team champions, bro. New tag team champions. Ziggler and Rude get it by pinfall, and the Street Profits are no longer up. And I guess that, you know, all of the smoke now belongs to Ziggler and Rude, man. Like, what was your reaction seeing the Profits drop the title. I mean, it's not like they have a major tag team division to begin with, right?
Yeah. It's like, you know, Vince like the tag teams that they're not tag teams. You know what I mean? Like, they just make together, pair together, and now you're a team. But don't get me wrong. You know, Rude, we know his fact. Story when it comes to being tag team, so he knows. You know, Ziggler, unfortunately, he has to be featured somewhere, somehow, you know what I mean? Because he's great at what he do, you know, whatever, you know, that dude is a beast. And it's unfortunate that he don't be used like one, like a good ace, you know what I mean? But he's one that he always delivers, you know, and I don't know, man, like, this is his, how many tag teams, you know, how he had with different partners. You know, he owns some Cesaro shit, you know what I mean? And that tells you a lot about them too, you know what I mean? It's like, come on, man. Cesaro for the longest, you know how to play. Like, I want him to be the face, the champion, you know what I mean? Like, to see him match up with him and Randy Orton, you know what I mean? As Randy Orton's leaving, you know? But, you know, that's what we see, but maybe in their eyes they don't see him, you know? Yeah, brother. You know, Street Profits, I don't know, they grow on me, but I'm still like, you know what I mean? Like, they're too soon. You don't want to do too much, but you know what I mean? Let it be, you know what I mean? On some, like, natural, you know what I'm saying? Like, happening shit like they did with, you know. Well, that's NXT. You can't compare it to the main roster. I mean, to the third roster. You know, when they did with Enzo and Cass, you know, they every time it's like, oh shit, you know, it grew on you. Yeah, they didn't push it on it, you know what I mean? So I remember, you know, that was one of the biggest pops when they made their debuts. But yeah, mama. Now, that show was pretty dope. You know, you see Seville. You know what I mean? Like, seems yep. like he's gonna be doing Sonya the Bill, son, doing some type of authority figure, you could think, or something like that.
Well, yeah, she's gonna have to be authority figure now that, you know, the other authority figure seems to be, you know, inside of a match at the Royal Rumble with Roman Reigns, Adam Pearce. Yeah. Yo.
What the fuck? But I mean, that gauntlet was fuego. You know what I mean? It was dope. And they had me like, oh shit, okay. And then it's like, what the fuck? Because, you know what I mean? Adam Pearce, you know what I mean? Big scrappy daddy, you know what I'm saying? And like, dude, you know, he knows. He's been around the block and shit. It's just, you know what I mean?
NWA champion.
Yeah, not the best NWA champion, but we ain't talking about that. But he, you know, he could do his thing. But man, like, I'm intrigued. Like, what the fuck are they going with? You know what I'm saying? What are they doing here? You feel me? Like, it's kind of weird, like, going with him. So it makes it intriguing. Like, what does this guy got in store? You know what I mean?
But they're planting seeds, bro. Here's what it boils down to, right? You got Goldberg on the card. Going up against McIntyre. You got Reigns going up against Pierce. I think the only reason why they did this dumb shit, and I'm not going, you know, but I'm happy for Pierce to, you know, to get a pay-per-view match. Don't get me wrong. But I think the reason why they did this, because it's another bald guy with a beard that Roman can face. So they're planting the seeds for Roman versus Goldberg. I mean, you know, there's already been seeds planted by Goldberg on the bump and through Twitter with Roman Reigns. So I think that's the only reason why they're doing this. And yeah, they're planting seeds, bro. Trust me, you're going to see it come to fruition by the end of this month or next month, right around Mania season. But I am going to say this. Overall, it was a great addition to have this much wrestling come back at once. I mean, it started off very, very dreary with Raw being a complete letdown. And, you know, here's my thing. If they're going to do something, goddamn it, do something next Monday to make up for that, because that was horrible. Worst show of the week was definitely Raw, Legends Night. But best show of the week definitely goes to NXT this week. Then, you know, followed by a MLW, AEW, and then SmackDown, because Adam Pearce kind of messed it up for me. But I am going to say this. On the rumor side, though, Jay White may be a free agent. Dalton Castle may be a free agent. Got some free agents out there. So they can end up anywhere. They can end up on WWE's radar. They can end up on Impact's radar. They can end up in MLW. They can be, you know, of course, NXT or A-Dub. So it's a lot of places these people can go.
Yeah, to me, the Jay White, it kind of like, it got me in a borderline. Because they reported it. But sometimes there ain't no spokesperson that came out and said it. But it's like rumors. You know what I mean? Like, to me, like, if it's storyline, you know what I mean? But someone doesn't know. It's true. Like, WWE, of course. Because remember, New Japan's contract, the way they do it, is like by year. You know what I'm saying? It always ends by the end of the year. You know what I'm saying? Or that first month, you know what I mean? Of the year. So, it's kind of like, you know, like weird. You know what I'm saying? Like, is it true or is it not? But, you know, of course, NXT's been linked to, you know, him. You know, which it will make sense to me if they bring him in, you know, in NXT. So he could know properly, you know what I mean, with the TV cameras and all that shit. And that would be dope. Dalton Castle, bro, I love Dalton Castle. That dude is nice. That dude's strong as a horse. You know what I mean? So if he actually get picked up, I could see him at AEW. You know what I mean? But I won't be surprised if he ends up saying NXT. Because dude, he could speak. You know what I mean? I just don't know what kind of, if they're going to keep the gimmick. You know what I mean? Like, kind of the what he's doing, unless he's going to reintroduce himself, and so he could show his, let's say, acting chops and, you know, his worldwide. But yeah, free agency is crazy, you know what I mean? Because now, you know, you have the guys that already got signed, you know, the Bucks. They announced the India show, you know what I mean? Like, so they're going to have a lot of moving parts, you know what I mean, moving forward, you know?
Yeah, man. A lot of moving parts, a lot of free agents, but, you know, this is just the first show, the first, I should say, recap show of the new year, 2021. More to come, of course, by the end of this month. I also got another interview dropping for you all, possibly real soon this week. Make sure y'all pay attention to all the social medias, you know what I'm saying, keep your eyes open, and definitely want to make sure y'all definitely, if you are inside the area, inside the Hillard area of Ohio, make sure you get your tickets for Ohio Wrestling Alliance Good Trouble going down January 30th. Listen, bell time is at 7:15. Doors open up an hour before that. Make sure y'all are there. Make sure y'all come out here and y'all definitely buy y'all some booze. Buy y'all some alcohol, some beer, some liquor if we have it, but you know, some White Claw, you know, that's gonna be there. Listen, all proceeds of the liquor sales goes towards PB Smooth's college fund that he has set up. So listen, I'm coming out there to drink, and you know, if you see me and you definitely listen to the show, you know, say what's up. I may just go ahead and get you a drink. Of course, this is definitely going towards the proceeds. It's a good cause. Good Trouble is definitely a good cause. Make sure y'all come out there to come watch Good Trouble. Some of the people on this card, I'll go through the card on next show. But with that being said, listen, we got, especially with the events that happened this past Wednesday, too much negativity can definitely have you unbalanced mentally, spiritually, physically, and emotionally. Spread more positive vibes, all right, people? After what we saw this past week, listen, positivity is definitely needed, all right? You know, listen, you don't have to go to the merch store and buy our merch for you. Buy it for someone who definitely needs that pick me up. Maybe looking down at, you know, the positive vibes on their t-shirt, their tank top, their hoodie, their sweater, what have you. May give them a reminder that, you know, things are going to look up, you know? So definitely spread more positive vibes. We don't need to be, you know, doing that craziness that happened this past Wednesday. That was just ridiculous. But with that being said, man, another thing that I noticed, a lot of people that were down there this past Wednesday didn't have on a mask. And COVID is definitely real out here, right? COVID is affecting people all shape, ways, and form. It's hitting people in their personals, it's with their families, you know. Either you have contracted COVID, someone you know has contracted COVID, someone's either beat it or someone's passed away from it, man. Listen, it's very simple to slow down the spread. It starts off with good hygiene, first and foremost. We don't need you to wash your hands. And most of all, wash your ass. Use soap, as Dre would say. Cheech, let these people know how they got to do this, man.
From face to ass, not ass to face.
It's that simple. And on that note, we out, people. Peace.
I don't gotta say what's up to you. I don't gotta say hey. No. Now I don't gotta act like I fuck with you. Bitch, I'm already paid. Hey. If you talk shit, then it's up with you. And that's where it's gonna stay. Yeah, cause I ain't gotta act like I fuck with you. Cause I'm already paid. Cause I got your bitch now in love with me. She's in love. Now I'm in this bitch now. It's getting ugly. Cause I got your bitch now in love with me. Now I'm in this bitch now, it's getting ugly. Yeah, I'm getting money by the millions every month. My bro just told me that he's good, he made a killing off the runs. I'm in Atlanta, but I'm bringing home Brazilians from the club. These women feel like I'm the one, I got Sicilian in my blood. Plus, big Tim and Hertz, they on my side. Got it up 8 figures while staying inside. Bought another new car, love the way that it glides. Killing y'all every year's on my mind. I don't gotta say what's up to you. I don't gotta say hey. Now I don't gotta act like I fuck with you. Bitch, I'm already paid. It's way too late. And if you talk shit, then it's up with you. And that's where it's gonna stay. Yeah, cause I ain't gotta act like I fuck with you. Cause I'm already paid. Cause I got your